Hey everyone, it's VGP7000 here, and today I'm going to be giving out my honest thoughts on the cancel culture thing, and I believe that cancel culture is becoming a huge problem in this Vion community, and the cancel culture thing is probably also the reason why the drama still goes on in the Vion community, even though the gacha community is probably worse than the Vion community. And thank God I never used Gacha Life, because Gacha Life is total shit. Anyways, I'm going to get started about why I think that cancel culture has been ruining the community. So, to start things off, cancel culture is basically a culture where so many people would go out of their way to cancel someone's channel because they did something bad. Like, for example, a crime, even though you cannot erase serious crimes that people did because the past is history, and you cannot erase serious past actions that people might have done. Like, here's a few examples: sexual harassment, doxing, and other things that are crimes. And besides, I really don't like the fact about it. Like, I understand that perverts and pedophiles are meant to be taken seriously, but the best way to take perverts and pedophiles seriously is to just call the cops on them and tell the cops what they did, and then just let the cops handle it afterward. But instead, there are some users out there who keep on doing this because of cancel culture, and the Vion community has basically turned into a cancel culture community because of these people sometimes making user videos out of one another, taking trolls way too seriously, and other things that increase drama, which is not similar to criticism. Now, I thought at first that criticism was just made up, but it's actually a real thing. But here's the main problem. So, according to Vittorio the Vioner 2003, he said that these criticism videos are starting to become old and overused. And the types of videos that he's talking about, like, he's talking about when people make videos showing screenshots of what a specific person did with music playing in the background. He said in his video about why cancel culture needs to be stopped that those types of videos are getting pointless, where someone just plays random music in the background while showing screenshots about what a person did. And Vittorio was also talking about people calling others clowns. Now, I still used to do that back like a few weeks ago, but I might stop calling people clowns because I really don't know if it's worth it anymore. Like, I know that it doesn't harass the person. Like, I know that they basically only say this for a joke, but honestly, I just think that the cancel culture thing is why the goanimate community became worse, and why it just went completely insane. And like, I understand about the video that Luke Animate posted, but I don't really know if I fully want to believe him, because even after he made that video, there was still drama going on in the goanimate community because of people using this cancel culture thing to cancel a person who did something bad. And the worst part is that about that past thing, even though I understand that past is history and that it cannot be erased, but the only things that you cannot erase from the past are serious crimes. But if people did something that's not even serious, then I don't think that needs to be brought up, even if it's from the past, because if someone committed a mistake in the past that's not even serious, people still feel the need to bring it up when it's not even that bad, because, like, sexually harassing people, doxing other people's personal information, and even making fun of their faces, now, those are a lot more serious than due to the fact of like, how many other crimes that people have committed out there. Like, most of what has been happening in this goanimate community has been sexual harassment. That has been the main thing that has been going on in this community. Like, every time I wake up to a new day, I always see more sexual harassment by all of these people, and I was also getting dragged into the dramas, and I've been trying my best to stay out of the dramas, but then at the same time, I just don't get why cancel culture is still a thing in this community. Like, the cancel culture thing is probably the reason why goanimate has just been insane throughout the years, because ever since we started 2018, 2019 and 2020, there has been nothing but drama in the goanimate community. And even though I'm still a goanimator and that I'm still in this community, I just don't like the drama that keeps happening in the goanimate community because it's way too much, and the drama in the goanimate community has gone way too far. And I already know that criticism is for advices only, but according to Vittorio, he's thinking that criticism would rarely ever change someone's behavior. And I do agree with Vittorio on this because I was basically saying this earlier, because if you were to give someone constructive criticism, that would rarely ever make them change their behavior unless they were actually willing to take the criticism that you gave them. But if they denied the criticism, they could start cyberbullying you. They could start cyberbullying you multiple times, because they're complaining about you making a video out of them. And if you get cyberbullied because of the person that you gave criticism to, you would just basically be getting cyberbullied a lot more because the person that you gave criticism to decided to deny it and then go insane on any of you who you gave criticism to. And this is honestly why I really despise cancel culture, because I just don't like the fact when people use cancel culture, when people use the cancel culture thing to just cancel someone who did serious crimes or things that are not even that serious. Like, for example, when Sparkleshine Gamer 2K7, which used to be Love Chan, I remember the time when she got called out by a few people for saying the homophobic FA word, and then that caused her to go on a 1 month hiatus because she received a hate base for saying that word, and that so many people made calling out videos out of her, and they even made talking videos out of her. Even a few people made live streams about her. And this caused her to take a 1 month break from the internet. And then when she came back from her 1 month hiatus, her topic about her saying the homophobic FA word basically turned into a dead topic because nobody else ever brought it up, and that people gained their respect on Sparkleshine Gamer again. And like, some people did not, and some people thought that Sparkleshine Gamer saying the homophobic FA word was taken very seriously. To be completely honest, guys, if you say a homophobic word, I don't really think that saying something like that is not meant to be taken seriously, because it's just a mistake, and saying a word like that is not even serious. And besides, there have been so many people out there who just cancel other people sometimes for dumb reasons, and I just don't get why people do that. And even one of my friends, which is Cat Ocean Pearl 6274, which is also known as Go Big Planet Mate 3854, he actually uploaded a video just recently giving out his honest thoughts on why cancel culture ruined the goanimate community and why it's still causing drama. And to be honest, I have to agree with what he said, because this cancel culture thing it's just a living nightmare in my honest thoughts. And I even saw Aziz's rant that he did on cancel culture, and I also had to agree with what Aziz said about cancel culture, because he even sent a video link on his rant video that he did out of cancel culture, and I saw a 12-minute video from someone, I can't remember the username, and he was speaking about cancel culture and why he thinks that it's a problem, and I also had to agree with him on that. So this is why I really despise cancel culture. And also, guys, If you wanted to get criminals off your mind, instead of constantly making user videos out of them, all you should do is just call the cops on them. Like that's all you need to do to criminals if you want to get them off your mind. Because what people have been doing a lot of times is that they've been making user videos out of criminals, which user videos are cyberbullying. And the reason how I can tell that user videos are cyberbullying and not criticism is because there can sometimes be violent things that are happening in user videos. And if you were to re-upload one of those videos about a criminal, not only can the video possibly get taken down for violence, but it would also prove that you would be cyberbullying them, and then you would try to disguise it as criticism, and then people would say that you're using criticism in the wrong context. So this is why I also don't make user videos out of anyone, and thank God I never did that. And besides, I already retired from criticism videos because I don't make them anymore for a specific reason, because I don't really like canceling someone over stuff that they did, which is not even serious. Like, here's another example. So when I still used to take trolls way too seriously back on my older account, that got terminated from February 15th, 2020, which was last year, since we're now in 2021. After I stopped taking trolls too seriously and learned my lesson, the topic about me taking trolls too seriously immediately became a dead topic, because nobody ever brought up the time when I still took trolls too seriously in the past on my older account, because I already learned my lesson about why trolls are only seeking for attention and why they only want people's reactions due to the videos that trolls make out of them. And also, guys, remember, do not ever take trolls too seriously, because if you were to take trolls too seriously, that would prove that you would be doing troll feeding, because trolls only do this to seek your attention and to try and get your reaction. And besides, if you took trolls too seriously, that would just make you look bad. So this is why trolls are meant to be ignored and not taken too seriously. Just remember about that, guys. Do not take trolls too seriously. Just ignore them, because they're only doing this for attention. So I don't really know if there's anything else I have to say about this, but I'm just giving out my honest thoughts on why I really despise cancel culture, and I'm just trying to speak out the truth about why I think cancel culture is a problem in this goanimate community, because it's just a serious problem. I swear, it's just a very serious problem. And I just don't know what to say. I don't know what to say. So yeah, it's just gotten to the point where it is too much, and I just don't like cancel culture. So that's basically all that I have to say for today. So yeah, I will see you guys in the next video. So this is me, VGP7000, over and out. See you all later. Peace.